guys have scuba dived or snorkeled in or near a coral reef site? Awesome. Do you guys have any specific memories or something that stood out to you while you were there?
There was water everywhere.
Water everywhere? Okay. Maybe colorful, lots of fish. It probably looks something like this. So you see a lot of fish, a lot of coral, very colorful, a lot of biodiversity. If you go to a lot of the same reef sites, it might look something like this. And this is just wasteland, basically. You see all the corals dead, there's no color, no fish, no life living there anymore. So why is this? Well, it's because of us. It's because of all of us. It's all because of the human activity that we are killing our coral reefs. So here we have a graph of global carbon dioxide emissions. So this is just specifically carbon dioxide. And naturally, across the years, carbon dioxide will increase, and that's normal. As you can see over on this side, it's from 1900, it increased gradually. But from 1950 on, you can see the influx of it and how greatly it's increased. And since 1950, we have seen a 600% increase of our carbon dioxide emissions. And that's because of us, from our industry, factories, our transportation, all those factors. So where does it all come from? These are a pie chart of all the places that we find not just carbon dioxide emissions, but also greenhouse gas emissions, which is the big picture we're looking at. As you can see, there's a lot of good things or things that we need, such as forestry and agriculture. Those are important. We need those to make food, to protect our forests. However, there are some of the bigger ones, such as energy supply, transportation and industry, those are things that are not super necessary. I mean, we need to use those, but there's things that we can cut back on. We can find more efficient ways and make less dangerous things that release the greenhouse gases into our air. So what does all this do to our ocean? Well, basically, the greenhouse gases, specifically carbon dioxide, it gets trapped in our atmosphere. And when it gets trapped, it heats up our ocean, so we find rising temperatures. We also find because it gets so packed into our atmosphere, it gets pushed down into the water, and it gets mixed in, and we see that it's being acidified, basically. So carbon dioxide is good for the water. We need it. There are a lot of mollusks, oysters, fish that need the carbon dioxide in the water to use that carbon. However, when we have the excess, like we have now, we find that this chemical formula process gets carried out. And because they can't use all the carbon dioxide, we see that it makes bicarbonate ions, which is acid. We're getting a lot more H ions in our water. So how does this affect our life, our sea life, specifically coral? Well, corals, they're animals, and they're very sensitive. And so when they get stressed, they have algae that lives on the outside of them, which is what gives them the color and also keeps them safe from disease and basically helps them eat and survive. So when they get stressed, the algae kind of just poofs off of them, which is also from the rising temperature and increasing the acidity of the ocean. And so when the healthy bacteria leaves, it goes through a process called coral bleaching. And this is where the algae leaves and the coral just is white. So it just looks white. And although the coral is not dead at that point, they're very vulnerable to disease. And they can bounce back, but because each year the temperature and acidity of the ocean is increasing, it's getting harder and harder for them to bounce back and actually survive. So they end up just looking like this. So these coral, they're not dead yet, but you can see there's no fish, there's no color, no food. And so when we lose the our coral reefs, we're losing all the fish, all the we also lose tourism because no one wants to go snorkel around here. So, like we learned in the previous presentation, deforestation is a big problem as well with biodiversity. And if you know more about that, you can connect that to the same loss that we see when our coral reefs die, the same as if you just took out a whole forest. And we see that since 1950, 30 to 40% of all our coral reef coverage is dead, just gone, since 1950. Additionally, by the end of this year, we will see another just 5% of all our coral reefs gone, just by the end of this year. So, what can we do? And this quote just is kind of makes you think. It basically says that we are connected to the ocean and our coral reefs, and we need to start thinking about them. And this may look like a big problem, because it is a big problem, and not just one person can fix it. But there are like little things that we can do, such as, I know since I moved here, I bike a lot to places. I don't use my car, everything is just really close. So biking places instead of driving or even carpooling can reduce your carbon emissions just from that. Also, I'm sure you all hear recycling, but that really does affect our emissions as well, because they don't need to get rid of the trash and release more carbon dioxide, so by recycling as well. Also, simply by respecting the environment. So like when you do go back and you do snorkel, you do dive in the ocean, respect the coral, because they're already really stressed out as it is. So don't stand on them, don't take anything from them, don't throw trash in the water, things like that. So basically, if we can just, we just need to be educated and we need to make smart choices, because a lot of people don't understand that the health of our lives and the health of the coral reef's lives, we're all so intertwined with each other that we need each other to survive. And these are just